Hi, Hilary here with WaterLogged, and today's episode of our fish feeding series, I wanted to talk to you about one of the things that I get asked a whole lot. Now, in my 15 years of experience as a hobbyist, as someone who's worked at a local fish store, as a public aquarium professional, one of the most commonly asked questions is, Hilary, I've got a really picky fish, I cannot get it to eat. What tips do you have? So this video, if you've got any picky fish, is for you. So there's a bunch of different products that are out on the market that act as appetite stimulants. That means that when the fish taste them on their food, smell them in the water, it's going to help to stimulate their appetite and kind of make them hungry and make them want to go after the food. One of those products is called Entice. It's made by Seachem, and it's kind of an oddball because it smells like bananas, which is a bit strange if you think about bananas in aquariums. It's not a smell that mixes, but every single time I've ever used it, it works phenomenal. And fish that hadn't eaten in a while or been picky eaters almost instantaneously go back to eating. So that is one product that you can look for to try. Now, another product that is out on the market is garlic, right? There's a bunch of different brands that make this, but today I'm gonna talk about the one by Brightwell Aquatics. It is garlic power, right? So let's open this up and smell it. I don't know about you, like leave a comment below. Let me know if you are a fan of garlic or not. Smells like freshly minced garlic, just, you know, fresh in the kitchen when you're cooking. And as good as it smells for us, the fish love it too. So when you use this, there's a couple different ways for you to use it for your fish, but I'm gonna show you how to use it on pellet food. Now, if you don't wanna use it on pellet food, make sure to look over, you've got instructions right here, they give you some different ways to use it. So one thing, go ahead and take our pellet food and put it in a container, right? So this is just for demonstration. I'm not going to be feeding this amount to my cowfish, Frank. He doesn't need this much. All right, so step after you've got your food, go ahead and shake up that little container. All right, you're going to pull it out. It's got a little dropper. So what your goal in this is to put enough drops on those pellets to saturate them. Now, once your pellets are saturated, go ahead and let that soak for about 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, these pellets will have been marinating in that delicious garlic power, and you can go ahead and feed them to your fish. Now, hopefully that will help to make them hungry and get them eating again. So that is one option that you have. Now, another option, and this is in this one's particularly for some of those butterfly fish and some of those angel fish that when you get them, they're wild caught coming in off those reefs. A lot of them are used to eating corals in the wild. They're used to eating sponges, and that's not necessarily something that we are able to replicate in our home aquariums or that we want to encourage in our home aquariums. We pay a lot of money for those beautiful, gorgeous corals. We want to keep them looking great in our tanks and get our angels and butterfly fish eating something that's meant for them. And that is where Angel Elixir comes in. Now, this was formulated to use some of those freeform amino acids that are found naturally occurring in sponges. So those things that they're going to be eating out in the wild, they have figured out a way to put it in a liquid. Now, similar to the other Brightwell garlic power, the Angel Elixir is another one. You're just gonna shake this up. You're gonna saturate your food with it, let it soak for about 5 minutes, and then you're good to go ahead and feed it to your fish. So definitely another one. If you've got some of those picky butterflies and fish that are out there, try giving this a go. Now, one of the next tips that I have for you, and this you should be doing all the time, no matter what, is making sure that any uneaten food waste is taken out of the tank. Now, this seems like a no-brainer, but this is the reason why I'm telling you for this. One, it's gonna help your water quality, but two, think about if you were a fish and say, you know, this is the food that I'm feeding every day. There's some food that is stuck in the tank that is just sitting in there. Over time, it's starting to go bad and it's probably not smelling all that pleasant, but it still has that original, some of that original smell of the pellet food. So when you go in the next day and refeed that food, the fish will have been smelling that food that's slowly going bad in the tank over the last 24 hours. It's not really gonna be that motivated to go ahead and eat that. So that's one of the really big reasons that I'm telling you to take any uneaten food waste out of the tank. Again, you should be doing this every single time you feed. Typically, I'd recommend what they don't eat in 3 minutes, go ahead and get in there with net and get any of that food out. All right, this is my last tip, and this might be a little bit controversial, but bear with me. If you have a fish that is being picky, that's really not eating, put them on a fast for a day or 2 days maybe. Fish will be okay. They're not gonna die if you put them on a diet for a day or two. What this does is it builds up the hunger. If you're offering them food every single day and they're smelling that food, they're like, I just smelled that. You know, they're not gonna be motivated to eat. But if they fast for a day, by the time you go to feed them the next time, they're actually probably gonna be pretty hungry and they're gonna be more likely to go after that food. Now, the first feeding that you do after a fast, I would recommend to try and make that their favorite food that they have eaten in the past. In addition to that, consider adding some of those appetite stimulants like garlic. That will increase the chances of getting them to get back into eating like normal. All right, now, you know, those are just my recommendations. That might not work for every fish, so use your discretion if you are trying that method. Now, the next part of feeding that I want to talk to you guys about today is how to transition your fish from, say, eating frozen food to eating pellet food. A lot of times when people get new fish in, they can be a little bit on the picky side, but they'll eat one specific type of frozen food, right? So they're still being fairly picky. Say they're only eating mysis. Well, mysis is good for a treat or good for every now and then. It's not something that you want your fish eating day in, day out. That's like, you know, us going and getting hamburgers all the time. We do need to get some other food in our diets. So my tip for this, you thaw out your frozen food, right? The first time you do it, you just give them that. The next day, when you thaw out your frozen food that they're already eating, add a little bit of pellets into that food. So the frozen food is gonna have some of those juices. As it thaws, that juice is going to marinate some of those pellet foods. That flavor from the frozen food that your fish are already eating is going to slowly soak into those pellets. Now, over time, you're going to increase the number of pellets and decrease the amount of frozen food that you're feeding. This will slowly get your fish used to seeing those pellets that are soaked in those juices, that are marinating in that delicious frozen food flavor that they like, and they will be more likely to take those. Now, this is something that you have to be patient with. It doesn't happen overnight. It may take a couple of weeks to get them to transition, but once you do have them eating pellet food, you are going to be ready to go. If you have to go out of town, you can set up an auto feeder with those pellets and your fish aren't going to have any problems. All right. Let me know if you try this and it works. Hopefully it does. If you have enjoyed this video, leave a comment and let me know, and I will see you next time.